My name is Clement Mulamba. I'm a postdoc at the University of Johannesburg in the School of Economics. I'm here at the EDEP as a research fellow focusing on trade. My research topic is re-examining South Africans' exports to other African countries using a spatial econometric approach. So that's the topic. And the motivation for this topic is that, as we could see, many researchers have pointed out that intra-African trade, or the volume of intra-African trade, is very low compared to other regions in the world. So African countries are not trading, or are trading very low amongst themselves. So we need to understand, why is that the case? And in the literature, many ideas have been put forward to explain that phenomenon. That include lack of infrastructure, that include also the structure of African economies. Most of these economies are economies that are based on the resources exploitation. So they exploit resources and export them to Europe and other countries. So Africa, because of that, is not trading with itself. So those are some of the reasons that have been put forward. But we need also to understand, whatever is happening now, currently, what are other characteristics that we can bring forth so that we can learn from those characteristics, so that we are able to trigger or to design or to inform policies that will trigger the expansion of intra-African trade. So my paper is focusing just on one aspect, that is exports. Looking at exports from South Africa as the exporter to other African countries. So I'm trying to re-examine this question because it has been examined by other researchers previously. But what we are bringing forth here is to say, while you are examining that, you need to take into account spatial effects or spatial interactions. So we are using a model that will assist us to analyze this issue. So that's why we are saying that the approach that we are taking is a spatial econometric approach. We are using what is known in the literature, the gravity model, but that gravity model, we are using it in the spatial econometric approach. So that's the essence of our work. And during the 3 months that we spent here at EDEP, we focused just on that. We collected data, we focused on the literature review, we specified our model and did the analysis and provided some discussion on the result that we obtained and drafted a paper. So this is in essence what we've done during the 3 months that we spent here at EDEP. This program is very helpful. I have to be very frank here. First of all, I didn't know about EDEP. Whereas when I came here, I found out that EDEP is doing a lot in Africa in terms of capacity building. EDEP is training African officials in different countries how to do macroeconomic modeling, economic planning, and many other issues, such as negotiation of contract in mining and other aspects of economic life. So coming here for me was very important. It opened my eyes to see what EDEP is capable of doing. But from the research perspective, This is very important also because today we are talking about the continental free trade area, which our leaders are trying to push forward so that it can also be a vehicle to expand intra-African trade. So our research is focusing on trade, and I think in one way or the other, our research is contributing to that debate that we have now in the continent. Once we know, once we discover the characteristics of what is happening in terms of African intra-African trade, then we'll be able to also contribute to that policy making of the CFTA. So that's very important, it's very encouraging, and we would recommend IDEP to continue in this way and to involve more students, particularly students at master's level, PhD level, because myself and few other fellows, we are we've got already our doctorate, so it's very important for those that are coming in this field to know about IDEP. And I've discovered that there are many things, or there are many areas where our students who are doing masters and the PhD can focus on. So if IDEP can take this process forward and work more with African universities, I think it will assist in one way or the other. That's what I can say for now. Thank you. I would like to thank IDEP and its leadership for awarding me and other fellows this opportunity to come and conduct our research here in IDEP, in particularly in Dakar. This is a great opportunity for me, particularly in my career, and to contribute also to the development from a research perspective of our continent. So for that, I would like to thank IDEP. I would like also to thank my university for allowing me to come and conduct this research here. What I would like to wish IDEP is that IDEP should continue with this work. IDEP should continue with particularly in terms of the communication area, because there are many Africans, particularly the young ones who are at university, they are not aware of IDEP. So I think if IDEP can take this opportunity, and we'll be ambassadors of IDEP when we go back to our universities and our respective countries, to propagate this message. So IDEP should work very hard in that area to propagate the message, to propagate what they are doing amongst African researchers, students, so that they are aware of IDEP work and they can also contribute in one way or the other. So I wish all the best for IDEP and its leadership to continue working for the betterment of our continent.